why should you use NASA's DIY podcast? It's engaging. I know the word is overused, but it's exciting for students to use their creativity to produce a podcast that they can share with the world. Then, when they add the NASA factor, they end up with a product that's, dare I say, out of this world? From an educational point of view, building a podcast can integrate the curriculum. Teachers can collaborate to help students see connections across subjects. When teachers of different disciplines lend expertise, students will create a better product. But wait, there's more. Building podcasts supports different learning styles. The auditory and visual learners can listen to and watch their podcasts to review the content and learn even more. The kinesthetic learner can perform demonstrations relating to the podcast content to add to the video. And because they're in the starring roles, students will watch or listen to the podcast repeatedly. The repetition reinforces the content. And of course, building podcasts with NASA's DIY podcast supports national education standards in science, technology, and engineering. Now here's something really important. NASA is a reliable source. When you want to be sure that your students are using an accurate resource on the web, you can trust NASA sites to be credible. Astronauts, space, rockets, and microgravity all add up to motivation. NASA topics fascinate students of every age because they're fun. Students want to use clips of rockets launching and of astronauts playing with food as it floats away. With the resources on NASA's DIY podcast site, you can create podcasts featuring you, your students, and NASA experts.